Hi everyone, thanks for stopping by. This is Marine for Lanfon, and today I have a center picture window card to share with you. It features the brand new Studpuffin stem set, and you will see that I've made a modification in the inside of the card. I'm going to start with the card base. I cut the main panel out of faux cardstock, as well as four rectangles out of Moonstone, Noble Fur, Number 2 pencil and Blue Jay cardstocks. I'm gonna use Moonstone cardstock for the sky, and I'm going to use different dies to cut borders out of these three rectangles: a stitch mountain border, a stitch simple wavy border, and an ocean border from the Shadow Box card Ocean add-on die set. So my small borders are cut, but they're still a little bit too flat, so I'm going to add some contrast using these tracings. My idea for this card was to make a natural environment for my puffins. Those seabirds live in the North Atlantic, so I thought it would be fun to recreate an Iceland landscape with colorful houses, mountains, and even the volcano that has an unpronounceable name. So now the borders look better to me, but I'm also going to add a little bit of hickory smoke distressing on the base to remain consistent with the borders. I'm planning to have a whale on the front of my card, so I'm going to use this small die from the Ocean Wave Accents die set to create an opening in the border. This way I will be able to put the whale tail in it. Now I'm simply going to stick my borders on the front of my card base, except for the ocean border that I will attach once the coloring is done. I'm also sticking a fog rectangle at the back of the card so I can write my message later. For the inside, I did some work off-screen, but it's the exact same process as before, except that instead of the ocean border, I added grassy borders. Now I'm going to make the middle section. I cut a center picture panel out of faux cardstock, and I'm not going to use the whole piece. I'm just going to cut a quarter strip out of it, and I will use this strip as a base for my puffin little middle seam. I fold it in half, and the tabs as well, using my bone folder. I apply double-sided tape on the tabs, and now I'm just aligning the middle of this strip with the middle of my card base, and I fold the tabs behind to stick the strip. To cover this strip, I'm going to need grass, so I cut a rectangle out of cilantro cardstock, and I'm going to use it to cut a grassy border. I fold it in half and check if it fits on the strip. I added Modlon distressing at the top of it, and now I'm just going to glue it on the strip. So the card base is done. Now I'm going to color my images using my alcohol markers. The trees are from two different stem sets, Winter Village and Yeti or Not. The volcano is from the Rawsome stem set. The cute houses are from the Winter Village stem set, and the whale is from the Mermaid For You stem set. The coloring is not done yet, but I wanted to stick some images on the front of my card. So I used glue dots to attach the volcano and trees. And for the whale, I'm simply trimming off the image to keep the tail only, that I put in the ocean wave slot. I add more double-sided tape at the back of the border and stick it on the front panel. Now I'm continuing with more coloring. More trees, of course. The puffins are from the brand new Stud Puffin stamp set. The big rock is from Mermaid For You. The boat is from Rubber Dub Dub. The eggs are from the Extra Amazing Easter stamp set. The small bow tie is from Hey There. And the tiny flower is from Bicycle Built For You. The small bicycles you see are very cute, but the card was too busy, so unfortunately they couldn't make it to the final result. So all my images are colored. Now I'm going to assemble everything, starting with the middle section. First, I fold the rock and the eggs in half and stick both pieces together. Next, to give the illusion of a nest, I attach grass elements around those eggs. I stick the rock at the back of the grassy border using liquid glue. And then I attach my cute puffins using glue dots. You can notice that I added the flower and bow tie accessories on them. Now we have two very elegant puffins. And I'm sure you noticed that too, but I also added white tops to the mountains. And now I'm just attaching the trees and houses using a combination of liquid glue and glue dots. When everything was attached, I added birds in the sky using a small stamp from the Happy Village stamp set. And next, I'm just stamping the second part of my sentiment to my stud puffin. I wanted to add smoke coming from the chimneys using a coordinating die from the Happy Village stamp set. But I didn't want those elements to be too noticeable. So I simply cut them out of vellum and glued them at the top of each house. I think it adds cute and subtle details to the scene. I'm finishing the card with the first part of my sentiment. I'm stamping the words "Sending Love" on blue J cardstock using clear embossing ink. Next, I plunge the paper into white embossing powder and I melt the powder using my heat tool. I trimmed off the paper to create a thin banner that I'm going to attach on the front panel of my card using glue dots. And that's it, my Iceland landscape is done. I added last minute details such as white highlights on the images and also tiny green scallops on the grass borders using a stem from the Ahoy Mati stem set. I hope you like this card, and if you live in Iceland, I hope it does justice to your beautiful country that I dream to visit someday. Thank you so much for watching. Have a very nice day. Bye!